another question, why do they dip? What is it with this constant bouncing movement the whole time? Well, the truth is nobody really knows, but there's lots of theories. One is that because they live in this river environment with a constantly moving horizon, by shifting their position of view, they get a good idea of their world. They're constantly seeing the fixed points in their world. It could be that it helps their vision when they're looking down into water, and it could be that they're advertising to other dippers coming up and down the river that they're present, because of course that white blaze on their front shows up really well when they bounce. But our editing team has another idea. They think that dippers do it simply because they've got a wonderful sense of rhythm. Come and dance with me. What's up, girl? I've been keeping my eye on your movement. I can't see no room for improvement. That's why I'm asking, B, so let's party, B. Come and dance with me. If I'm out on my own, then I can look at you, looking at me. If I'm out on a date, then I just shut my eyes, then I can't see. Get away from the bar, tell your boyfriend, call the job. Dance, dance, I see you dance with me, that's why I'm asking, B, so let's party, B. Come and dance with me. Super bad, what a giggle.
I know, what a treat, isn't it?
It really is.
What a treat.
Skylarks filling the sky, but insects everywhere as well.
I know. Well, look at it, all the nectar's here, isn't it? I mean, you know, because it's unimproved, it's not just grass. You've got all of this trefoil, which is a fantastic food plant for butterflies. You know, the larvae eat it. But of course, the flowers are just chucking out nectar. There's masses here.
Oh, look at that.
Look at this, one of my favourite plants.
It's gorgeous. It's an orchid, but what sort?
It's a bee orchid. And the neat thing about it is that this petal here has evolved to look like the body of a bee. And this plant actually produces a chemical to attract the male of that species. So it comes thinking this is the female, as it attempts to, you know, do what bees do to one another. It collects two little packets of pollen called pollinia and affects the pollination. Well, it does in other countries. The bee doesn't actually live here.
So how on earth is it growing?
Well, in this country, they self-pollinate to some degree, and then sometimes other insects stick their noses in there just by accident.
I mean, it's just looking at it from here. Look at that. It is a perfect little insect. It's got its antennae.
Yeah. And it's even fluffy.
Morning.
Morning.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Good. So, where's the nest?
See that second bush?
Yeah.
Pretty much in line with that.
How on earth did you find it?
Well, I can't really take credit for this one. Mike, our local wildlife expert, found it. And really, it's just by observation.
Is this one of the sort of trickiest nests you've had to rig?
Technically, no. But in terms of the behaviour of the bird, probably, yeah. They're really skittish. I think being ground nesters makes them ultra cautious. So we had to sort of introduce a dummy camera in stages over a week. But even then, when we swapped that for a real camera, the birds just wouldn't tolerate it. And I think it's that sort of big one-eyed monster thing, that, you know, the reflection off the glass or something. So we backed it off again and then we crept it in. And finally, I think we've got it.
Can we go and have a quick look?
Come round.
Look in. I can't even see it from here.
You're looking from that side. And then when I open it, the chicks may do their thing.
Oh my goodness, that's just amazing.
Oh look, there's a little one.
What's so astonishing as well is that they're not just nesting on the ground like our little ring plovers and the lapwings. They have actually made a nest, haven't they? But just sort of woven it in amongst the grass right on the ground. Absolutely.
And if it were in the open and they had their heads down, you just wouldn't see them,
would you? No.
So that down has evolved to look like grass.
That's the most magical thing I've ever seen. That was absolutely beautiful, wasn't it?
It was stunning, wasn't it?
Really?
Do you know what? I feel a poem coming on. yeah, I do. A singing firework, a bird of sunlight. Hark, how creation pleads. Then silent sea, a small grey bird that runs among the weeds. Edmund Blunden.
I prefer John Keating.
such a rotter.
Well, this river is called the River Wensum, and it runs straight through the Pensthorpe estate, and it is a beautifully looked-after river, one of the cleanest and healthiest rivers in Britain, and it is hopping, buzzing and plopping with wildlife.
Down by the riverside, down by the riverside,
yeah.
Down by the riverside,
I'm gonna lay down my sword and shield.
Down by the riverside,
I'm gonna study,
study one or more.
I ain't gonna study one more. Gonna study one more. I ain't gonna study one no more. Ain't gonna study one no more. I ain't gonna study one no more.